What's up, guys? Colton here from the SCF podcast, and I am back. Sims 3, Pets, Part 2. It's so exciting. I can hardly contain myself. That's how exciting it is. But, yeah. So, back in Sims 3. I am recording this on Tuesday night, and this was supposed to come out Wednesday. Not gonna happen. Gonna come out Thursday. I know, I lied, but, you know, I can do that because I'm in control of these videos. Right now, I think he's taking a bath because I am re-recording this audio. As I said in part one, because I lost the audio for parts one and two because I'm an idiot. I deleted them. But all that should be good in part three, which should be out next week sometime. Wednesday or Thursday. But you should check out part one. There will not be any links to it anywhere besides in the playlist with this video. Cause again, I am lazy, and you guys, if you want to watch the videos, you will find them. Yeah. So that's all I had planned to talk about. So the next, how long is this part? I don't know. Probably about 15 and a half, 16 minutes. So the next 15 minutes, 14 minutes are going to be probably pretty boring. Other than the fact that I have probably the most energy I've had. But probably the most energy in this part than all the other parts combined. Mostly because I recorded those about 1, 2 in the morning. Don't exactly know why I did that. But it is 10:55 right now while I am recording this audio. Much better than 2 in the morning. Mostly because I have school tomorrow and I kind of need a little bit of sleep. Other than that, no other reason why I'm doing them. I probably could have done them about an hour ago. Went on YouTube, just watch a quick video. And you know how that happens. You just blah, blah, blah. 15 videos later. And here it is. 11 o'clock. I don't remember at all what happens in this part. Besides, it's Sims 3 Parts 2. I don't have anything else to say about it. So what's going on here is sleep. Oh, I did have something. Okay, that's freaking Butters making a mess all over the place. Better clean that up. But anyways, okay. Stupid dog eating the couch that was already not a good couch, and now it's even worse. Anyway, I had a DS that I ordered recent, a week or so after Christmas, and yeah, continuing the tradition of having Butters clean up his own puddles. But anyway, back to the DS. The hinge on it was cracked, and like, you know how when you're holding it, the top screen is supposed to, stay in place? But it would just flop all around, like a giant dick. But, yeah, just flop around all over the place. So I finally got into GameStop, took it into GameStop to get, either get credit for it or my goal was to get just get it replaced. Because I want to play DS. And it was just a regular DS Lite, and it was $80 when I ordered it. So I go into GameStop, put my stuff on the counter, and say, "Yo, the hinge is broke. I need to get this fixed." So he types on his little computer, which it was the manager doing it. And I'm gonna be honest right now, I don't really like the manager of my GameStop. He just I had a couple bad experiences with him in the past, but anyway, back on topic. Okay, so he types on his little computer, and he wonders out loud, because it wasn't really a very good question to ask me. Oh, and shout out to On the Sims sitting down to pee. But anyway, back to my story. So I go in there, get all the stuff, he types in it all, and wonders, why was the DS Lite $80 when the DSIs are $80 in store? And I'm wondering the same thing. I was like, yeah, that's really weird. If the DSIs were only $80, I would have ordered that in the first place. But they're not. They were like 100 or so. Because it was right after Christmas. Everybody was buying using gift cards. So they jacked up prices. You know, all the good stuff. So, he says, congratulations, you're going to get an upgrade. Because DSIs and DS Lights are back to regular prices. On sale, I guess. He said on sale, but I'm assuming those are the regular prices. So, he gives me the DSi, just no box or anything, just gives me the DSi and the charger, scans it and everything. So, you know, I'm happy with it. I got it, the hinge works, all the buttons are fine. Plus another extra 30 days if it doesn't work right or anything like that. So I get it all set up and everything. But then, when I get home, and I'm playing it for a while, so I turn it off, set it on my desk, went to check a few things. But when I come back, I realize that the sticker with the barcode and everything on it is right on the freaking front or top or any, whatever you want to call it, the top of the system. Like, there wasn't a box or a sleeve or anything where the tag could have been, like the barcodes, price tag, whatever. It was just stuck on to the top of the system. So I'm like, great. So there's gonna be, so now I peeled it off, and it came off fairly well. There wasn't any, like, the sticker left, but there's an outline where the sticker was, and it's a little sticky if you rub your fingers over it. Hopefully, I'm hoping that the residue will eventually come off if I just keep, like, rubbing it where it is. Oh, and one other thing, it didn't come with a DSi stylus. Came with the regular DS Lite stylus, so it fits, it works and everything, but it doesn't fit snugly into the slot thing, which annoys me because I have OCD for that kind of stuff for no reason at all. Freaking loading screens again. Okay. But yeah, the stylus isn't the DS iStylus, which I haven't checked how much they are online, so probably end up buying one or two of those or whatever off eBay or something, just so my OCD can be cured or fixed for this problem anyway. I don't know, and I don't know what kind of skins and stuff they make for the DSIs. I may get something like that if I can find one I like. Because I don't like just the DS Lite I had. It was the loading screens. Why do I do that to myself? It was the what was it called? Oh, it was the Legend of Zelda limited edition one with the it was gold and had the Triforce on it and everything, which I like that. So that's why I ordered it like that. And then when I had to get it replaced, I was like, oh really? Because I knew I wasn't gonna get another one like that. So I'm gonna see if I can find a Zelda like skin for it. If not, I'm just gonna say screw it, I'll just stick with the black because it is a good color. Also, I'm gonna probably get some screen protectors when I get my styluses. And one more problem I had with it, the SD card little door thing on it, like, covers up the SD card port. It is a little loose, so when I'm playing, like playing Mario Brothers or whatever, and I'm moving my finger or like hitting the trigger or whatever for some reason, and my finger moves up against the door and makes a slight clicking sound. It's not like noticeable, the sound anyway, but I can feel it moving and it annoys me just constantly. So I have to make a conscious effort not to put my finger on it. But then I feel the stylus that's not flush with the system. So, don't know. But I do appreciate that I did get upgraded to the DSi, because they didn't do just the system for the system. They went with the same price, which was a good, which did, what's the word? I appreciated it, because I don't know if all GameStops have the same policy, which I assume they do, but that's just good. I liked it. I like the DSi. I used to have one, and I got rid of it because I never played it, but recently, yeah, I want another DS. Got the DS Lite after Christmas because I had gift cards and stuff, and so now I got the DSi again, which is awesome, and I'm starting to play my Wii more. I don't know why. I'm getting back into Nintendo, I guess. Not much. I'm still doing a lot of stuff on Xbox. As you can tell, in this and Minecraft coming out soon. And while I was in there, I picked up Rock Band for 360, because I had it for the PS2. And I have the guitar for Xbox, and you can just use your headset for a microphone. So I picked that up. It was with my power-ups card. It was 95 cents, I think, or 95, 96 cents, or whatever it was. But good deal. The achievements aren't that bad. It just, and I like Rock Band. Just something to pass the time. Not a quick 1,000 gamer score game at all, but it is. It's just a fun game. I have a few good memories playing that, so I just saw it and I figured I'd pick it up. I still need to get a drum set for it. I don't think I will end up getting another guitar, because I don't play with that many people. I'll probably just be doing stuff by myself, and I can always just do, like, I'm planning right now. I don't know if I'm gonna make videos in it or not, but I know for sure that I'm gonna be playing by myself. May end up doing a few videos, probably just of guitar stuff, because I don't want to have to, like, I don't really want to record me singing, just because it's utterly terrible. No, excuse me. Need to get a little sip of water here. Ah, yeah. Aquafina bottled water. It's the best. Just kidding. Bottled waters taste all the same to me. But, yeah, probably maybe a few videos on Rock Band. If not videos, then I'll be doing guides for achievements for Achievement Hunter. Not that they're hard achievements, just videos to make. Yeah. That's about it. That's all really I have to talk about. And the video is going to be ending here probably like 3 minutes or so, maybe 2 or 3 minutes. Yes, the one thing. I'm glad I have my SP still, because the DSi, I was just playing, excuse me again, I was playing Fire Red on my DS Lite. Oh, I can't stop burping. But DSi doesn't have the Game Boy port, which I know, but I know that's how it was. Just disappointing. So I have to, whenever I want to play Fire Red, I have to dig out my SP, because I really don't, I think I'm going to, I don't know what I'm going to do. Just play on the SP, I guess. Other than that, nothing really changed. I only have a few games for the DS. I have Super Scribblenauts, which is fun. Super Mario Brothers DS, or whatever it's called. There's too many of them. It is. Oh, it's the new Super Mario Brothers. And I also have Legend of Zelda Spirit Tracks. I played Phantom Hourglass, because it came when I first got my DS. It was my first DS was just the limited edition Zelda one, and it came with Phantom Hourglass, and I played that, and I loved that game. So Spirit Tracks was the sequel to that, Which is, well, kind of a sequel. It's Zelda. Zelda for DS, and I love Zelda. So. And I'm probably gonna end up getting Phantom Hourglass again sometime. And I've been looking at Skyward Sword for the Wii, because I've heard mixed reviews about that. But I want to play it, see for myself. Oh, and here, in the video. Back to the video, not just my personal stories. I can't figure out how to use a treadmill. I think I'm just stupid. But I can't figure it out. I don't know. I will hopefully figure it out. Because it won't be in the next parts, 3, 4, 5. Because I recorded those before I recorded this. But, okay, hopefully it'll be in a video soon. But the video is ending. So, I'm going to ask you to hit like if you did enjoy my personal stories. Subscribe for parts 3, 4, 5, whatever. And comment whatever you think. I don't care. Comment whatever. So, I will talk to you later. See ya.